Hey fellow animators, I'm Miloš Černý, and today we will finish this wolf run cycle we started in a previous video. So without wasting any time, let's get to it. So we have finished the pelvis, chest, head and tail animations in a previous video. All we have left from the main body parts are the legs. Let's close all the stuff we will not need anymore and open parameters for legs. The most useful thing to start with is lift plan mod for both front and back legs. This parameter affects how long are the legs staying on the ground and how long in the air. If we take a look at the animation in space, and if you focus on back legs especially, you can see they move pretty nice already. Second thing what I almost always do is to set target align for both leg pairs to constant 1. Why I do this is kind of hard to explain, and the change on overall result is seemingly quite small if you focus on it. But the ankles tend to act strange if you leave it on default values. They rotate below foot platforms, for example, even when the foot platform is without any rotation, and similar things like this. Okay, the basics are set, now let's focus on the back legs first, because they are usually easier to do with quadruped animals. Start with lift again and scale it so the legs move much higher. When we change point of view, they seem quite far from each other, so move them closer by changing position offset. Maybe even move them a little bit back, but that's a detail. Now, another important parameter is foot bend. We want the leg to be rotated towards the body in its extremes. So scale the curve up at this point. And a bit down at the other. And smooth out the curve like always. I ended up with something like this, and it seems to be working fine. We can now take a look at some secondary things. Swerve changes how far do the legs move from each other during the cycle. We can put them a bit further. Swing affects the thighs and how much they rotate out. Okay, let's keep the back legs as they are for now and take a look at the front ones. Again, start with the lift. When I leave the animation running like this without seemingly doing anything, I am looking at it and trying to figure out what I might change. If you ever animated anything, you probably know that this is something that you do very often. But keep in mind that after you watch the animation so many times, it will start to feel okay for you. Even when it's not, you will just get used to how it looks. That's why feedback from different people is so important to have. If you don't have colleagues or friends that might feedback you, post your works in progress on forums or somewhere on the internet to get comments on them. It will help a lot. Okay, you can see I'm already setting up foot bend. I am watching mainly the frames around the extreme and when the leg is up as well. It should be bent a little when it's moving forward. Also, if you check out this frame for example, the green front leg is the only one on the ground at the moment, but it's already bent so much. It shouldn't be. That's when the moving of curve points horizontally comes in handy. If we take a look at it now, it's much better. Now let's do something with collarbones. I am setting up overall offsets as well as changing the motions of different axes during the cycle. After we are done with those, we can again move to other secondary parameters like swing, to make thighs not clip into the body mesh so much. Now with swerve, I have started setting it up to limit the overlapping of the legs. But after a while, I have realized that actually the front legs should be the ones that are closer together and not the back ones. So I have switched the offsets, but then the swerve for the back legs had to be changed as well. You can see me fiddling with parameters a bit more to find a compromise of some sort. Maybe the negative swerve would work even better, but well, that's for you to try out. The last thing I want to show is that you don't actually need to do everything with procedural parameters. For example here, the tie is still clipping into the body. What you can do in situations like these is of course an adjustment layer. First, we will key the bones at frames 0 and 18. 18 because our animation is 18 frames long. Open up Curve Editor and set all the parameters of the bones to loop. Now, for example, at frame 12, we want to fix the bone. So just key it however you like. And do the same for all the frames you feel are bad. The same for the other leg. Now we have to do a similar thing for the foot platform, because as you can see at frame 11 the leg cannot reach it. Again, key the beginning and the end. Set it to loop. And at the frame 11 move it a bit closer. Now we can also check how it looks in space. And it's not bad actually. Of course, it still needs a lot of work. You will always find some details here and there that can be fixed. We still didn't do anything with eyes, ears and jaw, but this tutorial was meant to show you the basics of procedural animation in CAD and how to actually do something with motion layers. However, keep in mind that procedural animation is not easier nor harder than regular keyframing. It's a different approach and usually requires similar amount of time to finish like keyframing does. But it brings a lot of cool features which I have discussed in my older video about procedural animation. And overall is kind of useful to know. So again, I hope you enjoyed this whole series. If you would like to see more stuff like this, support me on Patreon or with any other way you would prefer. If you are my Patreon supporter, you can actually download this wolf model as well as this animation for free on my website. And as always, share, like and leave some comments. Thank you. I am Miloš Černý and thank you for watching.